Do you remember the last time I spoke about one of these cameras? I believe I even had long hair the last time I was talking about one of these cameras, so it's been a while. Techtober continues. New cameras continue to roll out, miraculously, all within the same month. So, next up on the list, Insta360 ONE X2.
You like my outfit?
You look like you know what you're doing.
Was that backhanded?
Janice says I look like a pylon.
No, pylons are bigger.
Okay. I look like a Teletubby, dude. Look at this. I'll put my jacket over top. I can't let these guys see me like that.
So when Insta360 said, do you want to check out the new version of the ONE X 2? We'll send it over. I was like, let's go. Just keep sending cameras. Techtober. We're doing this. MKBHD, iJustine, how? How?
So the last time Insta360 came out with a camera, I didn't really know what to think of it. Then when I started using it and realized you can reframe your shots after the fact, so you don't actually have to think about where you're pointing the camera because you've captured everything, that intrigued me.
So effectively you have an action cam that doubles as a 360 cam that's waterproof, that has a bunch of new features where you can choose the composition after the fact. It kind of makes filmmaking and just capturing video effortless, and it's supposed to take kind of a lot of that stress away for trying to come up with everything ahead of time.
So what's the deal with this? Like, I used it for a couple days. Let's be honest here, okay? I'm not gonna come out here and tell you that I've been using this now for several weeks and you need it. I don't know if you need it. I enjoyed it. I had fun using it, like I had fun using the first version. Now, for comparing this exactly to the first version, the fact that it's waterproof now, it could take all the mud and dirt and everything that was thrown at it on the weekend, no issues. You saw it was fully immersed in water, so the fact that it's much more robust and waterproof now as a version 2, that's a huge bonus. This is where it gives you the unique value over other products. If you don't have anyone else to help shoot, if you're worried about getting the shot, getting the right angle, this device sort of mitigates that because it films 360 and you're able to choose the composition after the fact. Depending where you're holding it, you have infinite angles. Behind you, it's beside you, it's in front of you, it's above you, it's wherever you want it to be. You can keyframe and program in what are seemingly camera moves, panning from left to right, from in front of you to beside you, to making it look like there's a mini stealth drone flying around the woods behind you because that stick's edited out of the footage. It's confusing to people that have never seen it before. They just think, how did you do that? That doesn't make any sense. That's where it's cool. That's where it's unsuspecting. That's why I like it.
A good ride?
It's a good ride.
Let's check out what you get in the box with the Insta360 ONE X2. You get a little rag to polish the cameras because there's two sides of the lens. You get a little battery case. you're getting a battery, and then on this side, you've got a little slot for the an extra micro SD. They give you a little soft case. I've doubled it to keep the charging cable in, which they also include. I do like this because it protects both sides of the lens, but then they give you this soft case as well, which holds the entire camera. So I would just rather use this. I flipped this over so it was lens down, and that seemed to do it. And then what I was doing was I was attaching this selfie stick thread on the bottom. I was collapsing all these different sections. Boom, almost hit myself in the face. And that's how I was storing this. So then at a moment's notice, pull that off, turn it on, bam, off you go. I do wish this extender, I wish it came in and out like this a little bit easier. That's my one complaint with this. It's just this is never really seamless for me. It'd be sick if it was like an umbrella and you could just shoot it out and then bam and it collapsed down. Something like that would be awesome. The selfie stick also doubles for a boom pole for my microphone. Use this little cloth here. So these two tabs, that's the battery. Oh, and that pops out, bam. Big battery right there. You can see the weather strip around it, the weather seal. Your micro SD card goes in the side, boom. And then you've got your little clip right here. That's where your USB-C goes into to charge the device. Now careful about these little things. They can pop off.
USB-C charging.
Oh,
just dropped the door. Be careful not to lose that.
Nice, beautiful screen on the front, power button on the side, speaker up here, and microphone. The UI is very easy to use. It's kind of like all action cams now, where you swipe up, swipe down, swipe left, swipe this way. A very intuitive. One direction is gonna be all your resolutions, one direction is gonna be like the camera mode, one direction is gonna be your media and the clips that you've looked at, and the other direction is gonna be settings. That's almost universally what it is now, so this works exactly the same, as well as being able to connect it to your phone, which I did very easily, super fast, right away, to the Insta360 app, where you can both preview your clips, edit your clips, mess around with all the cool features of your clips, change the camera settings, resolution, etc. So I kept it in 5.7K at 24 frames per second. Let's talk frame rates real quick. At 5.7K, you're getting 30 frames per second, 25 frames per second, 24 frames per second. That's your 5.7, that's max resolution. 4K 50, 4K 30, and then a weird one, you've got 3K 100 frames per second. So you are getting some slow-mo there at 3K. Now, if you are shooting in 5.7K 30, your runtime's about 80 minutes. That's good. So I was shooting through the woods. I didn't have to charge the battery. I didn't even have to swap the second battery in there. Color profiles, you got vivid, standard, and log. So that's great if you want a little more dynamic range out of your footage. Shoots raw photos. That's cool. And the lens is an f.2 aperture. Now, with regards to it being waterproof now, the rating is IPX8. So that means you can go down 10 meters, it's like 33 feet deep, without a case, just as is. Just take this and dive 33 feet. Your ears will probably explode before this stops working. I mean, dude, I go 9 feet and it starts hurting. Now, if you use the dive case, that extends the 10 meters to 45 meters. Now, if you're going 45 meters down with a 360 cam, like, I don't know what you're doing. I don't even wanna know what's at 45 meters. Dude, the sea scares me. Just wrapping up here quick, there's a lot of cool new features that I wanted to try on this that I didn't get to try. There's this one shot that we saw of a girl playing tennis. And what was it called again? Clone Trail looks so cool. I imagine John Hill coming to like backside 183 flip a gap and how sick that would look with Clone Trail with every step of that move captured and frozen as the frame moves forward. Now, if you want to edit these clips, you can edit them in the app. The editor is there. All the different features are there for you to use to get those keyframed moves, but they also offer a plugin for Premiere where you can edit those same clips on your desktop. So it's just kind of preference. I've used the phone app. Kirk's using the desktop app right now. So it just kind of depends on what you want to do. The Clone Trail effects, I believe, though, are only on the phone. Keep that in mind for certain creative aspects when using their app versus an editor. There's a lot of cool creative features that you can probably have fun with and take advantage of, which I was excited to, but I, in all fairness, did not have time to test. And with that said, I'm going to leave it right there. Thank you to Insta360 for sending this camera. More cameras for Techtober. We're gonna have to do a follow-up vid just digesting all of this together. You and me just talking about all the cameras. some real talk. There's a lot going on. There's a lot going on this month. It's happening fast. And I appreciate you sticking around and hanging around with me. So with that being said, hit the like button if you like this video. Smash it if that's something that you're into. Subscribe if you aren't already. And I will see you as soon as I fix this selfie stick. Oh, there, got it. See you in the next video. Bye.